We're here in Houston, Texas, for this afternoon's matchup between the Baltimore Ravens and the Texans. We were at practice this week with both teams, and just watching them, you could tell they're going to lean on the ground game a little bit more maybe than most people expect, which is going to surprise some folks.
Yeah, I think it's going to surprise a lot of people. It's going to surprise the opposite defense, there's no doubt. Might even surprise some of the people in the stands who wanted to come here and see these star quarterbacks. Well, it's going to be about these running backs today. Let's see who can win the battle.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. The Texans in the pistol. First and 10, and the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster. And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
Oh, would they ever. They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job, but also a solid job by the running back picking up some good yards.
And it's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. Good gainer there by Foster.
Arian Foster is so smooth, and he makes it look so easy. But it's got to be hard when you're talking about this league, picking up big yards like he did that time on that run.
First and 10. Ball's thrown incomplete. Great coverage there by the defense.
I don't know what was more terrible. That was a terrible route. Terrible throw by the quarterback. Oh, and what a shock. It's incomplete.
Gary Kubiak on the sidelines for the Houston Texans, a Houston hometown boy who's been in charge now of the Texans for quite a while.
Yeah, he's done a good job with this organization. One of his first moves was to go out and get Mad Schaub. That has paid off big time for Gary Kubiak. And I think the team has had enough success and the failures in the playoffs. I think it's toughened them up, Jim, and I expect them to be a better football team because of that.
Third down and 8. Intercepted. Nice tackle.
Oh, when a defense gets an interception early in the game, oh, man, will that give. Confidence, and it just makes them play more aggressive. So this is a very good start for the defense.
Joe Flacco will take it right from the center, and the give now to Ray Rice. That's a nice, powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Well, Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here, but, you know, somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense might have to put some weights in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle. Well, I know it was a short run that time by the offense, but it's what it's going to do for you long term. Keep running that football. Try to wear the defense down.
Offense lines up here. Third and 5. The Ravens get a first down. Tackles made. We watched them in practice this week, Phil. Practicing plays inside the 20. Let's see what they come out with their first opportunity today inside the red zone.
Well, you've said it many times. This is where you win or lose the football game. They got the quarterback and receivers to make it happen.
First and goal. Rice. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
So many things you could do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Yeah. Second down coming up. Handoff to Ray Rice. Left side. And he's in for the touchdown.
Good job on that touchdown. That puts him ahead. And it's always, of course, better to be ahead than behind.
Ravens getting set for the extra point. Makes the PAT. Ravens getting set to kick it away. Send it to the 20-yard line. Offense lines up here. First and 10. Challenging the defenders to the right side.
How about that? We just saw the fly route straight down the field by the wide receiver. Long throw by the quarterback and a nice completion.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Snap back to the quarterback. Out of the gun. Getting sacked.
When you're the quarterback and you see a blitz, you got to know you got to drop back, look at a receiver, and let it go. No hesitation is allowed. He hesitates, and the defense gets the sack.
Halfway through this first quarter now. Looks to his left. Gets a hand on that one to knock it away.
Not much the offense can do in a situation like this. Third and long, what you probably will have to do is either surprise them with a run or throw it short and hope somebody can make a play and pick up a first down.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Throws the pass. Houston in the end zone.
Good job by the offense. They get in there. They tie this game up. Now we'll see if the defense can take advantage of that momentum and keep it on their side.
Extra point is good. The Ravens' return team is ready.
Well, a lot of good things happened on both sides of football this time. How about that return by the return team? Good job, good blocking. Look at the speed of that guy running. They get the tackle from behind. They stop the touchdown.
And Rice is the receiver, sent out wide to the left. Going across the middle, he has the grab.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best.
Joe Flacco will take it right from the center. First and 10. Eye formation and a handoff. Tackled down at the 28-yard line.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Encroachment defense. There's a lot of extra weight out there for this jumbo set.
And the give now to Ray Rice.
Gain of seven.
Well, that was a nice run that time off tackle. And listen, this is a bread and butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block to free up that running back so he has a chance to get in that secondary and make a nice run out of it?
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground.
Rice. Good for three.
This team likes to throw the football in the end zone once they get inside the red zone. This is a nice changeup. They fool them. Well, they thought they were going to fool them with the run, but it only gets a short gain.
Quick drop back.
Complete.
Always a good job to pick up some yards when you're in the red zone. Nice throw by the quarterback, and he gets the completion.
The defense comes out on the dime. Handoff to Ray Rice.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
First and goal. Staying with the running game. End zone bound, and he's got the touchdown.
I'd say this run by the offense is just, it's arrogance. They just say, you can't stop us. And they lined up and just shoved it down the defense's throat. Nice run there on first and goal for the touchdown.
The Ravens with the PAT to come. And the extra point is good. The Texans ready to take that football down the field.
Pistol formation
as they go ground here, and he's brought down right at the 42.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home, they stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
This will be second down.
Andre Johnson on the deep pass, and they can't connect.
15 minutes down, 45 minutes to go. Back after this word from your local station.
The Texans' offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway.
Split backfield here. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. Incomplete.
You're near midfield. It's fourth down. What do? I got the answer right here. You punt it. Play field position. Make the other offense drive the length of the field to score.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Looking for an open receiver on the right. And now we'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Yeah, I'm sure you're really proud of yourself that time. You go for it on fourth down. You get it. I'll give you that. But I still think it was a bad decision.
Right where it had to be.
Perfect defense call that time. They allowed the catch. The coach on the sidelines going, well, what else do you want me to do? We had the guy double covered, and you still couldn't make the play.
First down here after the completion.
Peloti Nata takes the quarterback down.
Well, if your offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, then you got to help them out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out, too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
Play number six coming up on this drive.
Move.
makes the grab and keeps the ball moving down the field. That's a first down catch.
That time the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Mavaro, very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Go shotgun here. Can't hold on.
Well, he dropped the football, and there's no doubt why he dropped it. You have to look it in.
The Texans will approach this play from out of the pistol. Foster's taking the handoff for one.
I think you got to be a little more creative in the red zone than this. When you just line up and run the football like that, you're not going to get a lot of yards. And that time, they just got a short game.
Third and nine. He'll fire it out to the left. The ball's deflected incomplete.
Good job that time by the defender. Read the quarterback. He sees the receiver, gets in good position, and knocks it away.
The Texans line up in the pistol offense. The running back goes in motion. Looking to the right side and throwing. The Ravens turn the ball over on downs.
Well, that's four plays and out for the offense, and that was bad. Bad play calling, bad play, bad execution. Go to the bench and try to rethink what you're doing.
Joe Flacco will take it right from the center. First and 10, and Rice is going to take the handoff now. Got the first, and he's got some space.
Unstoppable.
The 30, the 20, the 10. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
Anytime you see a long run for a touchdown, what you got to look for is blocking downfield. Nice job by the wide receivers and everybody hustling, making a block. And a long touchdown run.
Got the hand up into the sky, and that means fair catch. First down, offense readying for the snap. He'll throw it over the middle. Could have been intercepted.
When you're going against a good quarterback and wide receiver in the NFL now, one of the ways to stop it is tight man-to-man coverage. You against him.
Foster's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, Jim, they didn't pull the defense at all. Second down, you run the football, hoping to make it third and short. Then you lose yards, third longs. They're hard to get in the NFL.
That pass was hurried.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Caught.
I guess that's how they're going to be today, isn't it? We're just going to go for it on fourth down. That time they go for it and they get it. Good job.
That reception gave them the first down. Midway, second quarter. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
There wasn't much there that time, so good job by the quarterback just throwing the ball and getting the catch and just getting a couple yards.
Split backfield here. Second down and seven. throws to the right. Ladarius Webb with an interception. They bring him to the turf.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
Pitta is a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play.
Almost intercepted.
Well, these are the kind of throws in the NFL, Jim. You just take for granted that if it's open, you are going to hit it. But the quarterback makes a big mistake, leads the receiver too far to the inside, and it goes incomplete.
Second down following that incompletion. Trying to overpower him. Here's the run out of the strong arm.
Well, these plays do look ugly when they don't work. It's second down, and you run the running play hoping to pick up a few yards to make third down easier. But when you lose yards like this, third long, tough to do. Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work. And they stop the offense that time.
First down. Here's the handoff to Arian Foster. They tackle him for a loss.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Looking for a receiver. That ball has been picked off.
Touchdown, Baltimore.
What an interception by the defense. And not only that, look at that return. They intercept the ball. On one side of the field, make a long interception return for a touchdown. That's how you win football games on the defensive side.
They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back.
There's a flag throw.
And he is tackled at the 44. That onside kick did not travel 10 yards. Arian Foster lined up in the backfield. They feed the running back.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Second and 11.
The pass complete. Touchdown.
Something you always got to be alert for nowadays in the NFL. The fade route. The defense caught off guard just a little bit. Nice throw. Nice touchdown.
Driving extra point is good. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. And it looks like the kicking teams recovered the onside kick. Johnson's lined up in the slot. Now first and 10. He had it, but the hit jars the ball loose.
That was a big hit by the defender that time. The receiver drops the football. I'll tell you what, I guarantee the next time he goes over the middle, he'll be looking for that defender.
The quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Second down, 10. Eyeing that left side. Knocked away, incomplete.
He did everything right, didn't he? The cornerback that time, he was physical. He stayed on the wide receiver. He was reading the quarterback. So it was easy for him to knock the throw down.
Now, looking at third down, he sends the halfback in motion. working that left side. He's got the grab, and he's got the first.
Nowadays, it's getting harder and harder to play this tight man-to-man coverage because you're not even allowed to touch these superstar wide receivers.
First and 10. Scrambling out of the pocket. We've got an injured player on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
Johnson's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Looking across the middle. What a hit, and the ball is dropped.
Let's just tell it like it is, Jim Nance. His receiver's not a very tough guy because he gets hit. It should have been a complete pass, but he gets hit. He just throws that football on the ground, and the pass is incomplete.
Third down and 7. Foster. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Running backs, they love counter runs. They know when a defense has been over-pursuing, so they make that fake one way, and when they cut it back, there's usually a great running lane there. Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than 7, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
And the quarterback is taken down.
This defense, they are definitely not faint of heart, are they, Jim? They will bring the pressure. Good blitz that time, and they take the quarterback down.
The defense pushed the offense back with the sack, and the offense needs 9 now on third down. Escape. The ball was jarred loose. The offense was able to recover the ball.
Nice job by the offense that time, even though they fumbled the football, quick enough and smart enough to get on it right away.
The Texans getting set to add 3 to the board. Leg with that one.
Well, the offense is confident that they can move the football, but they get no points out of the drive. Why? That was just a bad snap, hold, and kick. Everything went wrong with the mechanics that time.
That flag gives them a new set of downs. The Ravens now move the chains. They've got him down there. The Ravens signal for a timeout. They have 2 remaining.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down. Keep those chains moving. Give yourself 3 more opportunities.
They've got a first down now after that catch. And the give now to Ray Rice. Touchdown! What a run!
It's like money. How much do you need? The answer's more. And that's what you do when you're trying to get points in the NFL. Just get more. Good job by the offense. They padded the lead with that touchdown.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this 2-point try. Going put an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. The Texans ready to receive the kick. Signaling for fair catch. One more snap, and we'll head to halftime. First and 10. Chubb gets it over to Andre Johnson. So that's going to do it for the first half. Ravens are up here in this one. We're back here now in this one where the Ravens lead by 21. Danielle's got an update from the sidelines. Let's go to her now. Danny?
Guys, I got a chance to quickly speak with Matt Chubb during halftime. Right now his guys are trailing, but he told me he wasn't concerned at this point. He said, we haven't played our best football, but that's okay because we can still finish strong and get this win. That's it from down here, guys. We'll just have to see how things play out. Back up to you.
Thanks, Danielle, and now we'll go to the field. They face first down. And now here's the first snap of the second half.
And he's brought to the ground.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
After running it, it's second down. To the ground here. Going to lose yards here.
That time, I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it costs his team yards lost.
And Rice is out wide on the left. Third and nine, challenging the defenders to the right side.
And he's intercepted.
He's brought down.
Well, I have to say, that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know when you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. There's some shifting around in the backfield. First and 10. Looking for an open receiver on the right. And it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
Jim, that pass ends up incomplete because the defender, he just jarred the football loose with that hit. Nice job. Get that shoulder into the receiver, knock that football out, and get it to the ground.
Johnson's a receiver in the slot. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Well, when your team is behind, what do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
After the long game, let's see what they do here. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
Second and 22. Throws the pass. Elam makes the tackle.
There's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, the double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch.
Interception.
Well, nowadays, your linebackers, they got to be able to do everything. They got to be big enough to get in there and stop the run, and also athletic enough to be able to get in position and make an interception. Good job by the linebackers.
Joe Flacco will take it right from the center. First down and 10. Eye formation and a running play.
And this defense, they are tough. When you run that football, they got some men up front. And that time, they stopped that run just for a short gain.
And Rice has shifted out wide to the left as a receiver. He leaps up to grab it.
Good job by the play caller that time. Calling for the short pass. Even though it comes up short of the first down, it opens up many things that you can do on third. You can run a reverse, draw plays, screen plays, or if you want, you can still throw it down the field. When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Sticks to his hands.
Nice catch by the receiver, but it still doesn't get a first down.
And here we have second down. Just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
Well, the protection was bad. Quarterback didn't have the time. He's off balance, and he throws the incompletion.
And Rice has split out wide on the left here on third and five. Under pressure and incomplete. Offense lines up here. He brings it in here, and he's got the first.
Got to have a lot of courage to call these type of plays, don't you, Jim? And at that time, even though this team is winning, the coach decides to go for it on fourth down. Good play call, and they make it work.
J.J. Watt rushes the quarterback.
You talk about a blitz on the defensive side, it's all about timing. Disguise it to the last second and time up the snap of the football. They did it that time, and they get the sack on the QB.
Looking to the right side and throwing. On the money. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Rice.
Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
This long drive continues. Gets it again here. Going to be a tackle for a loss.
Well, this defense all over that play. They tackle the runner for a loss. Now we're going to have third long. Advantage goes to the defense.
Third and 12. He's looking to a takeaway. The tackle was made.
This defensive coordinator, he is one aggressive dude. He keeps going after this offense. And finally, he gets the interception inside their own 20-yard line and stops the offense from getting any points.
Offense lines up here. First and 10. Ball's picked off. They pounce on him there.
When you get an opportunity like this, you want to take advantage of it. The defense did. The opportunity was there. They get a chance to intercept the football. They do. Now, can their offense take advantage of this situation?
It's first down as they head to the line. Handoff to Ray Rice.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
That second down coming up. The give. Running to touchdown, Ravens.
Well, you got a lead. You drive down the field. You score a touchdown. Now we're going to find out if the other team can stay patient or will they panic.
Ravens getting set for the extra point. The point after try is in the books. Ravens getting set to kick it away. And he begins his return. And the tackle is made right around the 32-yard line. First down here. Throws to the right. And the throw is incomplete.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you hit the receiver down the field on a quarter route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
And now they'll try over again on second down. Gets away from the pressure. Throwing now to his left. Ball is batted down.
Nice job by the quarterback that time. Got outside the pocket, got away from the pressure, gave himself time, even though the pass is incomplete. Good job of avoiding the sack.
Arian Foster lined up in the backfield. Interception by Webb.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
Is usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time. In on the stop. Coming to the line at the 30. 15 minutes to go. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Jones in the slot. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. And that'll gain just a few yards.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Offense lines up here. Third down and two. He didn't look it in.
It's really simple. Keep your eyes on the football. When they're not on it, that's when you drop it, and that's what happened that time.
Joe Flacco will take it right from the center. The throw to the left. The Ravens get a first down.
Well, when you play this type of defense where you play cover three, in other words, you have three defenders playing one in the middle, one right, and one left, well, the weakness of that defense is going to be underneath. So slant patterns, they're pretty easy against this cover three.
The Ravens now move the chains.
Good job by the offense getting another first down. You can tell by looking down on the field, that defense, hands on their knees. They are getting tired.
First down here after the run. Back to the ground. A tackle behind the line.
Now the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
Second down. Another handoff. They break through. Tackle him behind the line.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Now third and 10 following the run. And the give now to Ray Rice.
I think the big decision is now, Jim, do you kick the football, take the 3 points, or do you go for it on fourth down? To me, you kick the football and get 3 points on the board.
No doubt about it. Put three on the board.
You got to take advantage of good field position. The offense doesn't do it that time. I know they get 3 points out of it. Nice kick, but still a letdown for the offense.
There's a flag out. Good piece of tackling.
Great attention. Offense.
The onside kick is not legal until the football travels 10 yards.
Hey, hey, watch the corner. Alert, alert.
Let's go.
On first down. To the ground.
Man, his defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job. Makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack.
And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster.
Good job by the offense. They're in the red zone. They're down by more than seven, but the defense, can you stop them and just give up the field goal try?
First down following the long play. Out of the gun. Trying to work that left side. Makes the grab. Touchdown.
The fade route, it's a big part of every offense now in the NFL. We see it here. Look at the receiver. Pins the defender inside. Beautiful throw to the outside. Fade for a touchdown.
The Texans for the extra point.
Oh, it's a fade.
And so they convert it here on the two-point try. Texans getting ready to kick it away. Here's the kick, and this one's just a little squib kick. He's brought to a halt. Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I just spoke with a Ravens official. The staff wasn't saying much about the injury other than it's not severe enough to keep him out of this one. So expect to see him back on the field shortly, guys.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The defense had that one covered.
That was excellent man-to-man coverage at time. When you want to shut down a receiver, really the only way to do it is to man up and play him one-on-one.
Third and five following the incompletion. That catch gives them a first down.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
First and 10. Catch is made. Going to take it the distance. The 10.
What an effort and a touchdown.
Even on short passes, accuracy is a big, big deal. When you put it on them right in stride, look what happens. They catch it in stride. They don't slow down, of course, and good things happen. Nice touchdown run.
Inside of the uprights. The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick. That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. Martin's lined up now as a slot receiver. The quarterback motions the wide receiver. Down the field, able to get a step on the defender, and he makes the catch.
Well, even though they're down more than seven here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence for the offensive coach that they can punch this in for the touchdown.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. First and 10. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Incompletion, forcing it into double coverage.
Good job by the offense getting in the red zone. Now you're down some points. You got to find a way to score a touchdown.
Martin's lined up in the slot. The formation here, shotgun. Ball is caught, and a good gainer. Let's give him nine.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course, it'll be a touchdown.
That defensive front looks impenetrable here on the goal line. He'll fire it out to the left. Got what he wanted. Touchdown.
What a tremendous throw by the quarterback that time for the touchdown. What confidence he has in that arm. Small window. Very little room to throw that football in there. He didn't worry about it. Fired it. Got the touchdown.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. How much does this sting? They get the touchdown, but still they fail to get the two.
Jim, I think it takes a lot away from the football team. It's a terrible decision. Now we'll find out if that 1 point comes back to haunt them.
The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. He'll get it out of the weak eye.
Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're a running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
Joe Flacco will take it right from the center. From the eye, they give it to the deep back.
What a good job by the defensive player there. Just flushing the running back and driving him into the ground.
And Rice is lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. The Ravens get a first down.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
This play set up by the long gainer, Rice.
Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Second down here.
Staying on the ground. He stacked up at that point.
Well, even though they have a lead here, it's late in the fourth quarter, you still got to be unpredictable. Keep the defense on edge. As I always say, make the defense react and not attack. So make them guess what plays you're going to run.
Ray Rice lined up in the backfield. Here it's a third and 10. Handoff to Ray Rice.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Wide receivers are bunched up.
Looks to his left, and he hauls it in.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets the completion. And there's some tight spots, not a lot of room, so you got to really drive the football in there.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion.
Ravens in for the score.
Well, that touchdown just put the icing on the cake, Jim, whatever you want to say, because now the lead's too big, not enough time for the other team to come back. Great job by the offense.
The Ravens lined up now for the point after. An extra point is good. The Texans ready to take that football down the field. They're not going to risk the big return, so here's the squib kick. And the tackle is made at the 41. Number 84. The Texans will go with the pistol on this play. First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left. That ball is going the other way. That'll stop the play right there.
Matt Elam is a really physical safety down at the University of Florida. He was a hard hitter. He's a hard hitter in the NFL and also pretty good at spying the quarterback and making the interception that time.
And Rice is lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Gains 20.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best.
Phil, before we go, how about a little chat about how much this win means?
Well, you know, Jim, let's look at it this way. It was just a nice win. It keeps your confidence up, and it just gives you a little energy to go out next week and try to accomplish it again. Well, that was a beautiful run that time by Jim. You're right to say it's the play of the game, and you got to give credit to the big, ugly guys up front. I'm talking about the offensive line. They were dominating. And when they dominated,